This morning, we shall practice the meditation which acts as a therapy to our psychophysic being. We may doubt whether it will really act as a therapy or not. Yes, it does. It is my personal experience. Whatever we practice, it generates positive energy, brings peace and harmony. Rest of it I'll explain later. We shall begin with Om three times all together. Let us try to take our consciousness to infinity. Infinity as blue space. Try to expand your consciousness as much as possible for you in the infinity, in the blue sky. Infinity is pure consciousness itself. Infinite pure consciousness expresses itself as the harmony of pure energy. It is this infinite harmonious pure energy in reality, in the force of life, try to feel that every cell, every molecule of your body is the harmony of pure energy itself. It is this infinite harmony of pure energy the force of life manifests itself as pure air for us. Repeating Om mentally, touch your right and left nostrils. Try to activate the two canals of respiration by the vibration of by the force of Om. The two canals are known in Sanskrit as Ida and Pingala. Breathing profoundly the harmony of infinite pure energy through both the nostrils equally, make it manifest in every cell and molecule of your body and feel that you are the harmony of pure energy itself. Slowly breathe out through both the nostrils equally. Breathe out pure thoughts only and pure love. Spread it all in all directions. Practice the process 3 times. It is this harmony of pure energy, life force, expresses itself as luminosity, infinite luminosity. Try to feel that you are like the rising sun full of infinite luminosity and infinite beauty. Try to feel that every cell, every molecule of your body is emanating the rays of the color crimson red or of golden. It is this infinite harmony that expresses itself as pure love, try to feel the waves emanating from every cell and every molecule of your body. Let these waves of pure love become dense around you. These waves of pure love give expression as pure intelligence. These waves of pure love as intelligence gives you the direct experience of the Absolute and also all that is relative. It is this experience, is the joy of knowing, experiencing, it is the joy of being, it is blissful. This infinite reality expresses itself as sound vibration. Intensify this reality in every cell and molecule of our body by touching and repeating the different parts of our body. We shall begin with the right eye. Just move your fingers on your eyes. We shall repeat the mantra together. Om Aim Hrim Om. Thank you. the lips.
Amen.
in between the eyebrows. Place your palm on your heart. Try to feel second stage. I do not know whether we will be able to make up the time.
Yes, whatever you like to do.
First, we shall try to reflect what is contemplative meditation. Contemplation on subjects. For example, most of you, perhaps all of you, know the Bhagavad Gita. The Bhagavad Gita begins, or the teachings of the Bhagavad Gita begins with the war scene. Don't be afraid. It is not physical war, it is internal war. Let us take the example of the king, blind king. It is not physical blindness, it is inner blindness, because the very name indicates dhrita means firm, rashtra, kingdom. This body is a kingdom. Now, who rules the kingdom? Let us say it is ego. But then, if ego is veiled by multiple forces of material world, one becomes blind. So how can one express oneself? So the inner blindness is more dangerous for our progressive life. So this is how one has to go on reflecting. There is one aspect. That means we need to eliminate ego-ism. Ism should be eliminated just to retain the consciousness of I. When one is able to retain only the I consciousness, it can be directed towards the infinite reality, realities of life. So that is how we have to contemplate. Let us take another example. All of you know the name of Draupadi, ideal woman. How she is ideal woman? She will criticize, saying that she had 5 husbands. No. She was united with 5 infinite aspects. What are those infinite aspects? The first aspect is called dharma, eternal law. What is second aspect? It is the eternal law that expresses itself as force, energy. The same force that expresses itself as the physical energy. When we need physical energy, are we not to follow what is called the eternal law for our progressive life? Then third is Arjuna, the ideal man, ideal human being of pure intelligence, concentration, efficacy, and power. So he is the ideal man, total man. Then who are those 2 others, Nakula and Sahadeva? Nankula means to the ideal personality, there is no classification, class distinction, or any kind of distinction. Man is man, humankind is humankind. Then who is that Saha Deva? Deva, divine. The man, ideal man, becomes divine man. So, these aspects, that is called husband, master. So we have to be united with that reality. So Draupadi is the woman who knew this reality, was united with this reality. That is why she is the ideal woman. Even today we remember this ideal woman to follow in our everyday life. So there are different events or incidents in her life. Every incident, event has significance. It is not mere story. It is not mere social way of functioning. It has deep meaning. So this is how we have to go on contemplating for our progressive life. Well then, there are other ways of contemplating. For example, in the Bhagavad Gita, the second chapter, the characteristic of a realized being, how he or she functions in life. For example, sukha dukkhe same kritva, whether it is pleasurable situation or disagreeable situation or difficult situation, one is not affected by it. You may say, yes, we are not affected. How can we remain non-affected? We have to live. We have to look to our safety, our progress, our well-being perfectly right. Now here, there is a significance. So if you get identified with the suffering, if the suffering overtakes us, so we are not able to detach ourselves from the suffering. So why worry about it? Suffering is there, let it be there. So my way of functioning is this way. And in life, yes, there are pleasurable events or whatever it is, or what we call pleasurable, agreeable, they're momentary. Today it is, tomorrow it may not be there. How can we be sure it is permanent? So here, in the contemplative meditation, one goes on progressing towards what is the real, which brings total satisfaction, which helps us to develop ourselves as a total personality. So that is contemplative meditation. Then there is a second type of meditation. We have to use our emotions. Negative emotions should become positive emotions. How can we convert our negative emotions as positive emotions? For example, you know very well the music. In music, there are different kinds of melodies. These melodies are the expression of our being. The question, how it is, melodies are the expression of our being. Take for example, illusion to music. What happens? A kind of joy starts expressing itself, in your being, and you start moving your body or clapping your hand, what? That shows that you are in it. You are that. So in that way, in the same way, any kind of melody is perfectly alright, which suits to your well-being. And also in music there is rhythm. Emotion, melody and rhythm. These three aspects are interconnected. Why rhythm? I think yesterday I explained. It relates the heartbeat, the life force that brings the rhythm to the life force. So we need to know as how to get into that flow of life, melody of life. Take for example, you say Om. What is there in Om? For a person who does not know what Om is, it's just a sound. But for a reflective person, Om is not a sound. It is the expression of one's whole self, being. Take for example, when you say Om, it just comes from bottom right up to your expression. Where does the vibration touch? Is it produced by something? It is just our inner being expressing itself. It is not a struck sound. Is not a created sound. It is soul that expresses itself. Om. I think we have a little time. I can give you an example. For example, baby is born. How does the baby cry? The first sound. Why the baby makes that sound? To show that the life is there. Life must be fulfilled. How the life fulfillment comes? The first, the what's called the milk that stimulates the life force. So mother feels that the child must be fed. So the child is fed with milk, that the life force. So that is why in our let us say pujas or whatever it is, we use milk. Why? It's not God that is pleased. It is our life force that is offered. Means so that our life force becomes more perfect, strong, to continue progress in life. So mother feeds the child. So when the child is satisfied, it makes a sound, a kind of sound, something like that. So, when the child is totally fed, satisfaction, goes into deep sleep, so in the same way, it is the final state of being. As the child goes to the final state of being, deep sleep, every individual is carried to that final state of being, or ultimate state of being. So that is why, say, in meditations or every auspicious undertaking, we use this mantra, Om. For every mantra, Om is the base. It is the source. Then we go to the third method of meditation on the light. How are we to meditate on light? Of course, take for example, there are people who in yoga practices, they use the method called Trataka. You are made to concentrate on the candle light. The lamp or the flame does not move, it is steady. The same way, you need to make your mind steady, consciousness steady. So that is one kind of steadying the mind, perfectly light. Now, we need to go a little further. What is called candle light, it is the Atma Prakasha, the self itself is the candle light. Well then, if it is that flame or lamp, it is there here in the heart. Heart is the center. In the Vedanta science, that is a beautiful expression. Atma Guhaya. Guha means cave. Cave is here. Atma or self is here, seated, emanating that light. So, you bring back the light here and go on intensifying the concentration on it. Feel, you become that light, not the burning light, but that light, infinite light. As I said the other day, for every light, the Atman, self, or infinity is the source. It is infinity that expresses itself as the light. So try to feel every cell and molecule of your body is expressing that light, crimson red clay hue or golden hue. Try to go deeper and deeper in it. So that gives you the needed peace and harmony, whereby the sense organs do not dominate your being, your self. So it is the self that establishes itself in you. So that is another way of meditating. Then there is a third way of meditating, third or fourth way of meditating. We begin with contemplation, sound, light. Now we come to the form. Both Christianity and Hinduism, they have got idols. Are they mere idols or ideas? Well, we can say they are ideas, but then we are not to stop with the ideals only. We have to go beyond the ideas. How can we go? Now, the representation. Take for example Jesus or Krishna or any other divine representation. Perfectly right. Every representation is the expression of the pure consciousness, infinity. So you bring the divine image, idol, to your heart center. Visualize the lotus, feel lotus is the seed for your ideal, place the ideal or invite the ideal to be seated comfortably on the lotus seat of your heart. Now, there are different methods of intensifying the consciousness. If you are not interested in what is called different methods of worship, then one can do worship of, it's called mental worship. We call it in Sanskrit manasa puja. That is one aspect. Now, we may not have enough time, patience to do all those things. But here, it is enough. Just place your ideal on the lotus seat. Just try to express your love to your ideal. You love your ideal. The ideal loves you. It becomes interconnected. The ideal gives you or blesses you or fulfills your whole being with the ideal's love. Every cell and molecule of your body is filled with the ideal. So, in the same way, your ideal is fulfilling, blessing you, giving you his power and force. Every cell and molecule of your body is being filled with the power and force of your ideal. The ideal is not only power and force, it is also full of luminosity. For example, as we practiced in our meditation, like the rising sun. Now, the ideal is emanating that light like the rising sun, full of crimson red rays or golden rays, all combined together, and the ideal becomes that light itself or sun itself, and along with it every cell and molecule of your body is emanating that light. So try to go deeper and deeper into it, and your consciousness becomes that. And this consciousness, like waves, becomes infinite consciousness, infinite intelligence, knowledge, and bliss. So these are the methods to go deeper and deeper into ourselves, into the infinite reality. So these are the four methods one can utilize according to the need and temperament. In the spiritual domain, one is not conditioned or controlled by any kind of dogma, doctrine, or whatever it is. For each and every individual has his or her liberty. We need our inner liberty. So, in the spiritual domain, everyone has his or her liberty. So we need to accept, love it, be in it, and be progressive. So that is why the meditation, or that is how the meditation becomes efficacious for our everyday life. Now, we have 10 minutes for questions.
Is there a way that you feel it?
We can't hear it. Can you repeat the question, Sean? We couldn't hear it. Can you repeat it so it gets recorded?
Yes. Let's keep the microphone closed.
My question is, you talked about negative emotions, how to translate positive emotions. Is there any method to think about or practice every day in our lives?
In our everyday life, we have resentments, we have disappointments, we have frustrations, we have anxiety, we have fear. Now, all these aspects express in our personality in one way or another. These are all negative aspects of life. For example, when there is resentment, whoever may come to you, that feeling is there, you are not able to conversant spontaneously with the person. And when you are not spontaneous, the other person immediately feels, oh, something wrong goes here. Even if he or she is your friend, rejects. So this is how the negative emotion starts expressing itself. And disappointment, the same way. Frustration is still more dangerous. Anxiety, still more dangerous. Fear. With the fear, you drag all those who are with you to destruction. You may say, no, it is a fact, it is a reality. So these are all the dangerous emotions that expresses itself in our everyday life. Now, how are we to transform these negative emotions as positive emotions? So as I said, the best way of doing it is listen to beautiful music which you love, the melody which you love. Try to be in it. So, as I said, melody which you love is yourself. So what happens is that when you are in it, the melodious energy or vibration starts vibrating every cell and molecule of your body. So when this vibration starts vibrating or manifesting, the what is called negative forces, after all, they are all forces of material world, conditioned, controlled, contacted forces. Whereas this is spontaneous. This force cannot be destroyed by any conditioned forces. So this goes on intensifying in you, and it eliminates the negative forces slowly. So you feel that peace and harmony. You start feeling, oh, after all, these are all momentary. I'm not worried about it. So you may say it doesn't come. It comes, but it has to be intensified. One listening is not enough. Perhaps you may need it 15 times. Perhaps you may need it 20 times. Perhaps 108 times. Now, there's a secret. When a person is initiated with a mantra, the person is asked to repeat the mantra 108 times every day, morning and evening. You can imagine why 108 times? It takes a lot of time. No, it is to imprint the positive energy in us. Well then, 108 has different other, what is called, significance. There are 108 vital points. What you call in Ayurveda, marmas, vital points. First, the vital points become vibrating it. So the vital points, they distribute the energy or force to other parts, its cells. As all of you know, the cells, they have interconnection. The internet works very beautifully in a more sophisticated way, more let us say efficacy is there. So here the energy, electricity comes from the mantra or musical mantra or whatever. So slowly the negative emotions, they are eliminated. You start feeling the needed energy, force, harmony, peace, intelligence to be progressive. I think I have answered your question.
Swamiji, you said about sound practicing meditation on the sound and the light and the form. So when you use sound during mantra japa, how do you integrate the breath with the sound? I have heard that you do that during inhalation and exhalation, and somebody saying you do that when you hold the breath in the kumbhaka phase. So how would you, what's the right way to do that? It may depend on the mantra, I don't know, but perhaps you might want to elaborate on
it. Yes. Now, the sounds, the ordinary sounds, the effect on our whole psychophysic. Take for example, you know the word God. God. G-O-D. You change it, it becomes dog. Somebody addresses you as a dog. Imagine how you feel contacted. You feel disgusted. You get angry and here what is called mantras, the expression of infinity itself. These vibrations, expressions, are beyond any of the manifest objects of creation. The mantras are pure expressions of infinity. Now, for example, in the yoga classes, they teach you pranayama. In pranayama, there is a system called Nadi Shodhana, activating the two nervous centers, making the life force go through the Sushumna, make it manifest in the entire psychophysic system. How it is done? For example, the mantra I is used. Generally, we use mantra I. As I said, it is the expression of all the infinite aspects. So what I do is that, for example, I close my nostril, right nostril, then I mentally repeat I, maybe two times, maybe four times. It depends upon inbuilt capacity. Then close the nostril. 16 times. If I breathe 4 times, 16 times I retain. Mentally counting, I. Then I leave it on the by the right nostril. Then close the left nostril, breathing with the same mantra, retain it. Retention means make it go upward, spread it, then breathe out. 8 times. So there is a count for every system of practice. If it is easier for you, 2 times to breathe in, retain it 8 times, breathe out 4 times. So this is the method that is generally prescribed for practicing pranayama. Or there are other mantras, for example,